Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. tries to entice American investors during his visit to the New York Stock Exchange. Pia Gutierrez joins us live from New York City on day two of the president's six-day working trip. Pia.
Tony, at a forum at the New York Stock Exchange Monday, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. told potential American investors that doing business in the country is a potential to reap the benefits of a vibrant economy. This as he assured them that sound macroeconomic policies are in place to ensure the Philippines' full post-pandemic recovery.
Amid strong cheers and applause from American traders on the trading floor, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. rang the ceremonial bell of the New York Stock Exchange to signal the end of the trading day at exactly 4 in the afternoon Monday. The honor of ringing the ceremonial opening or closing of the bell of the New York Stock Exchange, usually given to celebrities, CEOs, dignitaries, and other noteworthy personalities, was offered to the Philippine leader during his visit on day 2 of his trip to the United States. To mark his visit, Philippine flags were displayed prominently inside and outside the historic landmark building in New York, considered the financial capital of the world.
Ferdinand Romualdez Marcos Jr.
In an earlier forum, President Marcos Jr. thanked the NYSE for the opportunity to share how his administration is further opening up the Philippine economy and ramping up its post-pandemic recovery as he wooed American businesses to invest in the Philippines. He touted government-sound macroeconomic policies, which he says will help create a strong investment climate in the Philippines, such as the lowering of corporate taxes, the reduction of minimum paid-up capital requirements for foreign startups bringing advanced technology, and allowing full foreign ownership of companies providing public services, such as shipping and telcos.
To international investors, the Philippines offers high-quality labor, a large consumer market, and a wide range of fiscal and non-fiscal incentives. At the same time, we remain committed to maintaining sound macroeconomic fundamentals, providing a clear development roadmap.
But for Marcos Jr., the country's greatest asset remains its young and dynamic workforce, reason why the government is investing heavily in the educational sector and upgrading technical skills of workers.
We are, I believe, the youngest country in Asia. And with the graying of other countries around the region, this gives us an advantage in terms of, I suppose, the population dividend. And they are ready to take up the cudgels. They are ready to work for the country. They are ready to do what needs to be done to bring the country forward.
The president also noted his administration's thrust to further strengthen ties with the United States amid growing geopolitical and economic uncertainties.
I cannot see the Philippines in the future without having the United States as a partner. And although I was referring to the geopolitics of it, and I was referring to the political situation in the region and around the world, that certainly does continue to apply in our exchanges in the economic front. And many of the drivers of our early economy were actually American corporations. Many of the strongest corporate benefactors, really, to government and to the rest of society in the Philippines were coming from the United States. They provide the stability in this highly unstable economic, political, geopolitical, diplomatic environment. This is something that is central to our thinking when it comes to the economic planning for the Philippines.
Supporting the Philippine leader in his pitch to American businessmen was an elite delegation of the country's business leaders and CEOs, led by Aboitiz Group President and CEO Sabin Aboitiz, who also chairs Marcos Jr.'s private advisory council. Aboitiz, in his speech, expressed confidence in the president's plans to transform the country's economy.
So we're here today to support our president and his genuine efforts to revitalize this relationship and remind you of our commitment. We support his efforts to assure you of the integrity, of the stability, and the solidarity of his administration and the Philippine economic system, which is not without wounds, but neither without the determination to heal them. We in the business community believe in this vision. And as our longtime allies and partners, we hope you will too. I've seen many presidents in my lifetime, and they all have their strengths. The one we have today has quite cleverly gotten 30 of our country's busiest CEOs to voluntarily work for him. I know this because I'm one of them.
Also included in the business delegation, SM Prime Holdings Director Hans C., ITCSI Chairman and President Enrique Rezon, San Miguel Corporation President and CEO Ramon Ang, Ayala Corporation President Jaime Augusto Sobeldi Ayala, JG Summit Holdings President and CEO Lance Gokongwe, and Doris Ho, President and CEO of the Magsaysay Group.
It is clear you have a plan, you have an opportunity, and I know I speak for many business leaders and investors in this room that they leave today not only with a renewed sense of optimism, but a further enhanced and strengthened sense of optimism about the opportunities in the Philippines.
But while Marcos Jr. was heavily cheered inside the New York Stock Exchange, it was a different situation outside as activists held a rally to protest his presence on U.S. soil.
Tony, as we speak, the president is currently at the United Nations General Headquarters where he is attending the 77th UNGA opening, or the opening of the United Nations General Assembly. He's expected to give a speech there later this afternoon, which will articulate his administration's priorities, particularly on climate change, food security, and the rule of law. The speech is expected to happen at around 3 p.m. here in New York or 3 a.m. there, Manila time. Tony.
Thank you, Pia.